presence in India, with the view of engagement with India, for India, in India. We started with looking at how we can bring in collaboration between our researchers, between our students, staff, and also engagement with India across various aspects of student mobility, academic institutional link up, and research partnerships. Over these 25 years, block by block, we have been able to build a strong partnership base for Deakin University in India. As we stand today, we have 45 partnerships specifically looking at research engagement and collaboration through industry and academia, and also focusing on research that actually serves the communities we are in. We have had more than 10,000 Indian students study different courses at Deakin over the course of time, and I guess they're all over the world as successful alumni of Deakin University, doing various aspects and good work in their fields of education. Deakin University prides itself in building relationships and also building partnerships that mean and matter to the people in India. And this itself is explained by the presence of our Chancellor and our presence of our Vice Chancellor here with us today, celebrating the 25 years. In this week, we are doing a range of activities to work with India and see what we can bring from Australia and how we can collaborate better. Today we are talking about building world-class universities. And as you all know, in India, I think we need to do a lot more in the field of higher education. We need to make sure that our universities are in the top rankings in the world. We need to make sure that our research is leading edge and we are able to serve the communities. So today is a reflection of what can we do better and how can Deakin support the initiatives of building world-class universities. The four themes that we have today are leadership, education leadership, rankings and the role of rankings in international education, research and engagement, and digitization, because the world is moving to digitization and that's going to be the future. And then in the week we're also looking at working through the Indian School of Business tomorrow on integrated reporting. I will let our Chancellor speak about that in a few minutes from now. We're also going to be looking at women in leadership, and we will have some very senior women looking at how they can support and initiate more activities and more synergies to make sure that we have women leaders supported. We then go on to looking at social responsibility for institutions and how that can impact societies, and in that we're doing a session on CSR redefined. You do know that the Prime Minister of India has talked about that very specifically, and we as Deakin University believe very, very heartily in that, and I think it's that that gets us going and looking at how we can engage in societies.
What it is that we do. A couple of things I wanted to say. We're a young university. We've been here, as the Chancellor said in the opening address this morning, for nearly half of our entire existence as a university, we've spent that time in India. 25 years here, our namesake, Alfred Deakin, who was the second Prime Minister of Australia, also a young country after settlement, and making sure that we lived up to his aspirations that a country such as Australia should reach out to India. Mostly because he was interested in water. He spent much time here, and he saw that water was so important, and when he got back to Australia, different kind of country, big land mass, few people, also had a problem with water. And his view was we should get to know each other because we could solve the water problems of both our continents. Interesting. But here we are today, a large university, number 10 for research in Australia, number one for learning satisfaction, and our biggest connection to the media here is, of course, we're a very significant brand in this country in terms of the number of people, number of Indian citizens who choose Deakin Australia as their university of choice for their education. We are very proud that we've managed to build that kind of reputation across what we see as the disciplines of the future: engineering, most particularly materials and composites, public health, absolutely, the problems of public health, of cardiovascular, of obesity and of diabetes. and then going on into sport, sport technology, sport management, and of course, cyber. What are we as a global nation going to do about cyber? I wanted to spend a bit of time on our research. Over the last period of being in India, Deakin has invested $11 million in country in our Deakin research institute and what we do. This has mainly been to invest in postgraduate students and in technology in our great partnership with Terry Deakin Nanobiotechnology that many of you came to the inauguration by Prime Minister Modi with our Prime Minister Turnbull in 2017. That 11 million has got us where we are today. We have now committed to another 9 million consolidated up for PhD scholarships in country over the next period of time. One of the things I wanted to say to you about that, we decided to do research in country for two reasons. Firstly, to give back. Secondly, to learn. To learn about India's biotechnology without nanotech. One of the unintended consequences of saying we would do in-country PhDs, to the women in the room most particularly, the unintended consequence was that more women were successful in achieving those PhD scholarships, and they, of course, were people who, for all sorts of reasons, cultural, domestic, etc., were not able to go to a foreign country to get an international education. But they stayed here, they've got their PhDs, and are now contributing back in India to the research endeavours. I see that as, and particularly in International Women's Week, March the 8th, of course, was International Women's Day. I think that's been one of the great outcomes.
This trip is a voyage of discovery for myself. It's one thing to hear about the strategies, the plans, and the vision of what success has come from that. It's another to actually come here and directly begin to experience that. A key mechanism that Deakin has developed and implemented with great success in the research and innovation space to engage with India is the Deakin India Research Initiative, DIRI. This was only set up formally in 2009, since then we have already seen more than 2,500 students enrolled directly through that program with the Deakin India office. And in a short period of time, that's an amazing set of engagement, really about the researchers and academics of the future. Our Vice Chancellor has referred to the $11 million already invested in DIRI. There will be another $9 million over the next 3 years in research scholarships to really build that momentum further. Now, this has been a key conduit in the Australia-India relationship because it's enabled academic expertise in Australia to be linked with leading India research institutions, universities, but importantly also industry. And as a consequence of that, research partnerships have been formed, the training opportunities that have been provided have a particular flavour to them. And I'll just add a little bit to the list of those partners, and it begins to really convey that we have been really fortunate to engage with some of the best in your higher education and research sector, but also some of your leading and growing companies. So we have IIT Madras, Terry, which we've heard already, AIMS, the India Oil Corporation, JIPNA, the GE Technology Centre, Madras Diabetes Research Foundation, Steel Authority of India, Biocon, Sankara Netralaya, the Vision Research Foundation there, and Bharat Forge, and many more. In fact, it's a list of 45, so I'll stop there.